So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new video on my channel. In this video I'm gonna show you two clubs who I was playing with in online seasons. These two clubs are only 3 stars and yeah, it was really fun to play with these teams. It feels like you are unbeatable with these teams, especially with the tactics that I was using. So I'm gonna show you in this video the tactics that I used, and yeah, maybe you can try it out, and yeah, hopefully it will work for you just as good as it did for me. I want to thank you very much for watching. Of course, please drop a like under the video. Please subscribe to my channel, because most of you viewers aren't subscribed yet to my channel. It would be really amazing if you would do that. It's free, so why shouldn't you do it? If you subscribe to my channel, you will be sure you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. FIFA 20 is a bit dead, but with these teams it's really fun to play with, in my opinion, so that's what I am doing at the moment, playing with 2 or 3 star teams and having some fun with it and share it with you guys, so hopefully you can have just as much fun as I did. I was in division 3, I'm in division 2 right now. Some people are asking, what division are you? Most of the times I am in division 2. Sometimes I am dropping back to division 3. Sometimes I'm trying out a lot of different tactics, and yeah, that's why I'm losing sometimes, and then you will be going back to division 3. Sometimes I'm at division 1 when I'm playing really serious with the best tactics I know, but division 1 is really hard for me, so most of the times I am in division 2. So by saying that, this were the match facts. As you can see, we had a lot of chances, we had more possession, and we had a real deserved win here with the Colombian club Junior. That's the first club that I'm gonna show you. They have 2 amazing players. We have Borja the striker and we have Hinestroza. Both have a special card in Ultimate Team. I was playing Ultimate Team for a few months and both cards I had, they were really amazing for me, and I thought, well, let's try this club out. And this whole club was really amazing. Let's show you the formation. It's a 4-2-3-1 wide formation. I already made a video about it. And for this club, it's a really good formation as well. So the 4-2-3-1 wide with the goalkeeper Vieira. I hope I'm saying all the names right. Pedrajita is the right defender. Then the center back Rosero, and the other one is Viafara. He is a right defender, as you can see, but I'm playing him as a center back because of his pace. All other center backs are really slow in this squad, so that's why I'm using a right defender. This center back has 63 pace. It's not that high, but it is okay. As you can see here, we have Mera, only 48 pace. Let's see, do we have another one? This guy, just 60 pace, and this one only 57, so that's not a lot. Here we have Gomez, also not really enough pace with 50, so that's why I'm using a right defender, because of his 86 pace. At least one of the 2 center backs needs to be really pacey, about 75 or higher, so that's why I'm using him. Then we're going to the left defender, it's Fuentes. Then we're going to the midfield, Centre is the right midfielder. Then we have Moreno, I need to say, and Higuita as the central defensive midfielders. And Hinestroza is the left midfielder. This guy is really amazing, 88 pace, and yeah, dribbling is really good, and he has 4-star skill moves. So that's really amazing to have in an only 3-star team. Then we're going to the attacking midfielder, that's Cardenas. You can also play him as a left or a right midfielder, but I like to use him as a central attacking midfielder. And the most incredible guy of this team is Borja. He is really good at shooting. He is not really fast, but he is not that slow also. His physics are really good, his dribbling is good. Passing could be better, but it is okay. And yeah, just his shooting, almost every shot on goal is a goal for this guy. Then we have one special player on the bench that I was using as a sub, and it's this guy Gonzalez. You could play him as right or left midfielder, or use him as a central attacking midfielder, and that's the position where I use him the most times. Cardenas, I was switching him for this guy around 60 or 70 minutes, so you have a fresh player on the midfield and use that to score some goals at the end of the match. So then we are going to the tactics. There it is. I use defensive style balanced with a width of 5 bars, depth of 5 bars. Offensive style possession with a width of 8 bars, so pretty wide, because you are playing for possession, so playing the ball around. You want to have as much space on the field as possible, so that's why I'm using a really wide formation. Players in the box, 5 bars, corners, free kicks, both 3 bars. Now we're going to the instructions for all players. All defenders are just default, so the left and the right defender are going forward sometimes, not all the times, but sometimes. Really nice to have an extra option when you are attacking, playing the ball around. When there is not an option, sometimes your right or left defender will run a bit forward, so you have an extra option to play the ball. Then we're going to the central defensive midfielders. Both good passing lanes, stay back while attacking, and cover center. So the other one the same, cut passing lane, stay back while attacking, and cover center. So we're going to the right midfielder. The only thing I changed is chance creation is stay wide, support runs is get in behind. The same for the left midfielder, stay wide and get in behind. Then we're going to the attacking midfielder. I changed nothing for him, everything is default. And the striker, the only thing I changed is stay central. So that's it for Junior, and yeah, it was really fun to play with these guys. And then we are going to the second team I am showing you in this video, and it's Shanghai SEPG. And it's a Chinese club, so there are a lot of Chinese players. I really don't know anything about the Chinese players, but as you all may already know, all those Chinese clubs have at least 3 good players. And also for this team, this is a 3-star team, but in front you have Oscar, the ex-Chelsea player. You have Hulk, the ex-Porto and St. Petersburg player, the Brazilian striker. And you have Arnautovic, the ex-West Ham player. So 3 really good attacking players, and also all the other players are not really good, but they are just decent. So all those Chinese players on the defense and on the midfield, they are just decent. And with the 3 guys in front, Oscar, Hull and Arnautovic, you can score your goals, as you are seeing in these clips. And yeah, I get a lot of comments sometimes. Well, dude, in what division are you? Your opponents are really like trash. Well, most of the goals you're seeing are far in the second half. Maybe in the first half, it's hard to play against these players. But when you are in front with 1 or 2 nil, and your opponent most of the times are going to play constant pressure, and because we are playing possession, it's really easy to play the ball around. All your opponent's players are running forward trying to get the ball, and when you are passing really good like here, you can create a good one-on-one goalkeeper chance, and with a player like Hulk, that is a goal for sure. So we are winning this with 5-2, as you can see here. It's Dutch language, sorry for that. But we are in Division 2, you can see. And yeah, you can see my record with my main account here. And we did a really good job. We had 90 shots. We had 14 shots on goal. We had a possession of 59%. So really amazing stats for a Division 2 match, I think. And now I'm going to show you how I did that. So this is the club, Shanghai SEPG. We're going to the formation, and it's a really old formation. It wasn't really good working in FIFA 20 for my feeling, but with this team, it was really amazing. We're going back to FIFA 70, FIFA 18. The 4-1-2-1-2 narrow formation was the meta formation, but it isn't anymore. But for this club, it was really amazing. So the 4-1-2-1-2 narrow is the formation I was playing with this club. Then we're going to the lineup. Hopefully, I was saying these names right, but the goalkeeper is Yan Yongling. We're going to the right defender. It's Wan Shengqiao. He Huan and Shi Ke are the center backs. And then we have Yu Hai as the left midfielder. Then we're going to the central defensive midfielder. Chai Hao Kang is the most defensive midfielder. This guy has a name like he's from Russia or Armenia or something. It's Akhmedov. Really good midfielder, 74 rating, medium work rate, so that's pretty good for a central defensive midfielder. But he's playing as a central midfielder, but he is the most defensive one to keep the balance. This one, he is the most attacking midfielder of the center midfielders. Mira Mejian, he is calling. Left-footed, weak foot 4-star, so that's good. And he has a high attacking work rate and a medium defensive. So he is making more runs forward, and the other one is more staying behind, and the central defensive midfielder is just staying behind. So that's a pretty good balance, I think, on this midfield. Then we have the attacking midfielder. We already say his name is Oscar, the ex-Chelsea player. You can also play him as a central midfielder or as a left winger, but on the attacking midfield, he is just wonderful. 77 pace is good enough, 79 shooting is good, passing is good, dribbling is good. So he will create a lot of chances with his good passing, and with the two strikers you have, it's really easy to score some goals because the strikers, let's go to the strikers. Yes, there it is, Hulk. You can play him as a right winger, but for my feeling, he is not fast enough to play him as a right winger. So we are playing him as a striker. Weak foot is just 3-star, so you need to know that. So don't shoot with his right foot a lot. Use his left foot. 4-star skill moves, so that's good to have. But his shooting and his physicals are really amazing, especially the physicals. Not a lot of players with clubs with 3-star have a lot of physical players, so use Hulk, use his physicals, and you can create your chances by passing the ball to him and then just give a through ball to Arnautovic or something and score your goals. The other striker, I already said, Arnautovic, weak foot 4-star, skill moves 4-star, pace 80, 82 shooting, passing is good, dribbling is good, also his physics are good. So you have two really wonderful strikers for a 3-star team. Then we're going to the tactics. But defensive style is just balanced for my feeling at this moment in FIFA. Balanced is the best working defensive mode, with a width of 5, depth of 5, so not too deep, not too much back, not too wide, not too small, just everything balanced and you are okay. And other thing, possession is the best way to play at the moment, also for my feeling. You can play the ball around when there is an opportunity to counter attack, especially when you instruct your players to go deep, making runs forward. You can also play some counter attack football, but when there isn't an opportunity, your players will make themselves available and you can pass the ball around. Don't rush too much forward, just pass the ball around, wait for the right opportunity to create your chance and score your goals. So also a width of 8 bars like the junior club, really wide. You're also already playing a really small formation, so it's really necessary to play it wide, because otherwise all the players are running in the same space and there is no space to pass the ball. Players in the box, 5 bars, corners, free kicks, both 3 bars. Then the last, the instructions of the players. All the defenders are just default, that's good enough. Also, like the junior club, you want the left and the right defender to make some runs forward sometimes, especially when you are not playing with a left and a right midfielder or winger. You need those guys when you are attacking. Sometimes in the midfield it's really really crowded, a lot of players, and you want to pass the ball to left or the right to create some space, and then you need these left and right defenders. So all are default. Then we're going to the defensive midfielder. Good passing lane, stay back while attacking, and cover center. That's the instructions I almost always gave to a central defensive midfielder. Then we are going to the central midfielder. Only thing I changed is stay on the edge of the box for the cross. The same for the other one. Stay on the edge of the box for the cross, because I don't want them to run into the box when we are there. We already have three amazing attackers. We don't need these guys. Just everything else is default, because the work rates are already good for the midfielders. So we don't need to instruct them to do something else. Then Oscar, he is just default. Hulk, stay central. Arnautovic, stay central and get in behind. He has not really much pace, but 80 is good, especially for three-star teams. Most of the times the defensive players of your opponent has around 60 or 70 pace, so your striker is almost every time when you're making a run faster than the defenders, so that's good enough. And when I'm playing with two strikers, I like one to be like a playmaker, make themselves available for a pass, and the other one making the run. So Hulk is available, especially with his physics, so you can pass the ball to him and then you can give a through ball to Arnautovic or something. That is working really wonderful. Well, this is the end of the video. I hope you liked it. I hope you will try it out yourself. Let me know in the comments what you think of it, and hopefully we will see you next time. Have a great day. Bye bye.